Hello world, Mr. Resistor here, continuing our Alpha journey. So let's see, I did some checking yesterday, and fortunately I hadn't closed the Eve appraisal page I used to set the price on the contract that I sold to myself yesterday, and discovered that I forgot to include the ships. So, made myself a new contract. So now I've got some hulls to work with. So, I think we will go with let's go with a slasher again today, because we need 10 kills. A lot of loot. And the slasher has the extra high slot. So we should have some guns. Did I not? Yes, I did. All right, there we go. And tracking computer. How do I control with another ship? Oh, remote tracking computer. Right, okay. Not what I need. Tracking enhancer. Target paint. Warp disrupt and weapon disrupt. Okay. Do I not have a salvager? Alright, well, let's add that to my list. rigs, but I'm not going to bother with those right now. Maybe this one. Let's see. Increase agility at the expense of armor. Yeah, not super relevant. Okay. Oh, yeah, right. Oof. All the way to Lurtmar. Okay. Small processor. Overclocking. Unit. One. So that's an obvious market shortage I can address with one of my other characters. Yes. And we will set that destination. don't produce a lot of normally I don't produce a lot of T1 rigs, but seems like now might be a good time. In fact, kinda seems like manufacturing in general has taken a hit. I would say since the price change, if I had to guess,
warp drive active.
If I had to guess, probably a lot of people who are multiboxing have stopped.
Docking request accepted.
That's probably a whole lot of industry players. What a jerk.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
So might be wondering why why I keep doing security missions, and
warp drive active.
The main reason, so we should use that up. The main reason is skilling spree. It's kind of the most reliable way to get a decent number of NPC kills in a short period of time, right? Ratting can be hit or miss. combat anomalies, you know, are also somewhat random. Security missions are pretty reliable. The other reason, though, is
warp drive active.
Loyalty points. So so if we come here, so right, so Boundless Creation is who I'm usually doing my stuff for.
Warp drive active.
And essentially there's kind of two things that I'm inclined to buy with it, right? One is augmentations.
Warp drive
generally
active.
Speaking, you know, it's cheaper to buy from a loyalty point store. It'll save you some ISK. The other is faction ammunition. Which is essentially you need 5,000 rounds of whatever the standard ammunition type is, plus loyalty points, plus some ISK. and that will get you 5,000 rounds of the faction version of that ammo type, which generally is a bit better, right? So when we get back to Boundless Creation and Hack, I'll check the loyalty point store and see if I can get some action phase plasma. That'll improve our damage output. You know, maybe not enough to make the difference that we need, but it will be an improvement. Let's see, that there.
Warp drive active.
And just for the record, I do not think this is a good fit. But you know, it'll probably
docking permission requested.
It'll do
docking
the job for this mission.
Accepted.
And it's not going to fare significantly worse than my other ships have in PvP, should I end up in that situation. Alrighty.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Yeah, so, anyway, point being, there are benefits to doing security missions, even if they are not, like, your main thing that you're into. If nothing else, the skill points are probably worth it. Honestly, I would even say that skill points are the primary and most important currency in EVE Online, right? Because that's really what depends, what determines what you can and can't do. As a general rule, it's not that hard to earn ISK. I mean, if you're talking about wanting to get up to like a billion, then that could be difficult. But you know, I've done it a few times. I typically don't have that much on hand. Even on any of my Omega characters, but I know I can get there if I need to. You know, I know that, God forbid, if I lose another Orca, I can afford to replace it with a little bit of work. Although that is more difficult now that I don't have a battleship available. But we're working on that problem. And in fact,
warp drive active.
I kind of have to say that even though I'm mostly doing the novice outposts, trying to cap those, and a lot of that just has to do with time constraints. The part of this whole PvP thing that I'm actually the most interested in is the hacking part, right? The data retrieval. And I will most likely be doing more of that.
Warp drive active.
That's why I bought 5 probes and only what, 2 slashers and a rifter. I mean, part of that was just because of what was on hand, but because I haven't done a mining fleet in a while. 4 kills. That's mildly annoying.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Oh, it's just fireworks. Yeah, that is a lot of fireworks, though. Is that a typhoon fitted with all fireworks launchers? That would be truly bizarre. Man.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Okay. Nope. Here we go. Hope I don't die. Alright. Yeah, definitely not enough tank on this fit. It is probably going to do poorly in PvP. That might be a tomorrow problem. Since we're coming up on 40 minutes here. All right. Okay, cool. So we did sell that stuff. So that's good. Sold a few other things, so I think when I get back to the station I might might put some more stuff up for sale so we can pull in a little more ISK. And maybe tomorrow we'll fit one of those probes and head back out for some some more of the hacking sites. Because that's honestly what I've been, I mean, not just what I've enjoyed most, but the what I've had the most success with. I think we can safely say that as both a player and a character, I lack the I lack the skills for serious PvP. This is not a surprise. Never been a PvP player in this game, and I haven't really been much of a PvP guy in any game in quite a while. I used to be decent in first-person shooter PvP, but that was 20 years ago. And I think it's safe to say that both my skills and my reaction speed have declined in the intervening years. Other wrecks. Just not showing up for some reason. Very weird. They were not showing up for some reason. Thought I had turned music back on. Did I not? I turned it off. That's a good level.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Alright. So let's go real quick. Okay, so we've only got one available, but that's okay. Let's check our loyalty points. Do we... Yeah, there we go. So, 1,200. 1.2 million-esque. We get some Republic fleet. Phase plasma. So, let's see, ammo should be up here. Right, so just looking side by side here. Right, basically all the same, except a slight boost to damage. Right, 10 to 11.5, 2 to 2.3. Shield based damage, armor based damage. So, yeah, pretty good. Now, the other thing we want to do is we want to sell some stuff back to my other characters. So let's see if we can't. Not seeing that. Right, let's go ahead and move that. We'll add window capture. There we go. Okay. So I'll go ahead and move my stuff over, so that'll be a little bit easier to see. So you can just kind of select stuff. Every time I do that to myself. All right. Hit Control C, Control V over here, put the list in there. What is... Man, alright. So this is all just kind of basic stuff that's used for manufacturing, right? These are used to create rigs. These are used for invention. These are also used as an invention. They're optional though. This is used, let's see, let me go ahead and paste this one. Right, this is right, used to make some structure components. And that these are also used in some things I like to make. And these can be hard to find. Otherwise I might just sell them on this character. So settings, right. Persist appraisals for later, yeah, 90%, right, we're doing 90% JITA, set JITA here, we submit, and this gives us our detailed list, and our ultimate price. So... See if I can. Cool. Right. I did include that guy in there. I did. Okay, so now I will create contract. It's going to be private. Doesn't affect the price at all, as far as I know. Receive 35 million ish. Next, finish. Yes. So go ahead and close that. So that takes care of a significant portion of the income that I'll be looking to bring in. Let's see. Is there anything? would be worth something. For missiles, Arbalest are the top of the meta. Second best is typically whichever one has the numbers. And then the rest of them kind of suck. So. So that puts us right up to basically an hour, which means I think we'll be done for today. So until next time, have a good one.